Welcome guys, welcome to my new tutorial on Spanish Tree. Spanish Tree, we're going to talk about the last property of layer 2 suite. You know, the last time I talked about how we switch packets, how we prevent loop, and for security purpose. Okay. Then, I'm going to talk about Spanish Tree. Since Spanish Tree as it is the primary objective, that is, the purpose of Spanish Tree is what? To prevent a loop on the layer 2 network bridge on the switches, so that there won't be something called broker storm or in which can shut down all our networks. So what are the spanning tree terms I have here? I have the root bridge. Now the root bridge is the bridge with the lowest and the best bridge ID, that is the lowest ID in that network. So the switch are going to elect the root bridge, so the one that has the lowest priority ID or it has the lowest MAC address is always the root bridge or root switch. The switch within the SCP elect a root bridge, which is a focal point of network, or all links, that is all links they create, must always link to the root bridge. Now no root bridge are all those all the routers that are not root. And the exchange bridge protocol data put bridge protocol data unit update the STP, that is Spanish Tree protocol topology database. So not that what a bridge protocol data unit, that is BPD. So this is an information that I receive and transmit from one state to another to configure the network. So they are being each switch has its own passes its own PDU to the next switch. Message to the next switch until it goes around the whole network, containing information about what the Spanish Tree protocol. So what's bridge ID? So bridge ID is what the switches in the network use in electing the root bridge. The one that has the lowest bridge ID is what is called the root bridge, as I said earlier. Now what is port cost? Port cost is based on bandwidth, that is the bandwidth that is what associated with the port. They were called post cost. For example, now I'm going to talk about the each bandwidth and what and its related cost in a few minutes. So past cost is what is a unique path that leads what that leads to the root. So this path cost is what is being added together until from one switch to the other until you reach what the root bridge, and it's also depend on what on the bandwidth. So the root port is the link with the lowest part, that is when you talk about something the root port, that is if you have a root bridge or root switch and now it's connected to one of the switches. Now the switch interface connecting to the root bridge interface is what they call what the root port, in which it must have the lowest path cost to the root bridge. So now designated port is determined divided by the best lowest root bridge, that is designated port in so designated port is defined by the best lowest cost to get to the root port bridge compared to the other port. Now the forwarding port is on its port speed. So instead is a root port or is a designated port. So that's a forwarding port can be, and the port in the root bridge or root switch are all forwarding ports. Now the backup and alternating ports, they are the one connection that is the infrastructure that connects to the LAN. It's a spoken line. They are all known as what backup and alternating ports. So now what there are five different transition states to a switch port. So for example, number one is either the first one is what disable state, second one is the blocking state, listening state, learning and forwarding. Now if port is in a disabled state, then it doesn't participate in the frame forwarding at all. Nothing. It's a port is a listening to, that means the word just listening to BPDU. It doesn't forward frame. But if the port is in a listening thing, that means that what it now starts to listen. We listen to PDP and it's ready to forward anything. Now if the port is in learning frame, then if a port in a learning frame, just listen to the frame, learn its root and populate the math table. So and a forwarding port, that is a port that sends and receives all data frames on a port. So now the switch populate the MAC table. The switch populate the MAC table in listening and learning state. So now I told you earlier that for the port course that is used to calculate the port course, uses based on bandwidth. Minimum one, that is the 10 megabyte the physical cable that was connected to the port, that is maybe I'll be having RJ45 or LC or LX connector for fiber, then it's out and have a 10 megabyte per second, that is it's what maybe the that give you an ethernet KPIs, which means that I have a maximum of 10 megabyte per, that means 10 megabyte per second. So that means that what the port the cost allocated to that attribute to the port is 100. For 100 megabyte per second, the cost is 19. For 1 gigabyte, that 1 gigabyte or 1000 megabyte per second is 4. While it is for 10 gigabyte, which is what 10 megabyte per second is what is 10,000 megabyte per second is what is 2. So the higher the bandwidth, the lower the cost. And I told you the lower the cost, that is the ones that are the best route to the root port is one that has the lowest path cost. So now there are different types of spanning tree we have. We have the IEEE, that is 802.1. We have a PVST plus. We have a IEEE 802.1W. We have 802.1H, and we have the rapid PVST. Now, IEEE 802.1 is also called spanning tree. It's not called spanning tree. Common spanning tree. It is really slow and it requires fewer resources. While the PVSTP is Cisco proprietary version, that is, it provides a separate 802.1D spanning tree instance for each VLAN. This one is for what? Each VLAN. The first one is what? Just the common spanning tree. This one is now, it's also, it has its VLAN, that is, it has 802.1 spanning tree instance for each VLAN. So it's also slow, but have multiple root bridge, and it provides efficiency. And the next one is 802.1W. It's called a rapid spanning tree. It is faster. It has a faster convergence and with single SCP instance. 802.1 is it map multiple VLAN upon each other. That is, it's the same processing. So on top, it's right on top and under spanning tree. So that's called a multiple spanning. It's also called multiple spanning tree. So why the rapid PVST? It is Cisco's version of RSTP. That is of what 802.1.11. In which PVST plus, that is in which it acts like it's like two in one. The first one, the number two, number three, all hold in this number five. So I think the combination of these two is in this number five, in this rapid PVST. So instead of it takes the properties of the second one, in which it adds an instant on each VLAN, and it takes the properties of what the 802.1 level, that is in which it adds a faster convergence. But it has a downside with it, but it uses what CPU power. So now that now we are I have PBDU guard and port fast. So since port, you know, when you put a cable that is into a switch port, and with the other end of the cable is what is connected to maybe a switch or to a host, it first turn from green to amber, from amber it now turn to green, stuff like that. You need to load. Now that's when it's taking from blocking to listening to learning to forwarding. That's what is going through the fast strategy five transition states. So now the port file can prevent the host from being potentially unable to receive DHCP or DHCP. That is, immediately you put when you put the port fast to when you enable a port pass on the interface, it makes that information to converge very, very quickly and fastly. I mean, very, very quickly. So we can use a platform, a trunk port connecting to a server. We can use a post part on the trunk connecting a server on a router, but you cannot put a post part on an interface connecting to another switch. It's very, 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 it's not done. but was unearned on an access port. But from switch to switch, it's not done. But you can correct it from switch to router. So, but from switch to switch, it's not done. It's going to cause a lot of damage. So, and it's advisable that if you enable a post pass on the port, then it's allowing you to put a PBGU there on it, because it's going to, in case you mistakenly plug it to a switch, it's going to disable that port and change that port to what, to an error mode, error disable mode, in case you plug. So that, so it's just like anybody can forget anything. You can forget to plug the stop inside the switch to the switch. So, but when you enable it, then that means what, you are safe. Because if you don't enable it, don't enable PDU, and you enable a post pass on a port, you connect that port to another switch. That's serious. But PDU guard is going to make sure it's guarded from any protection, from any damage as well. So, and we have Ethernet. Ethernet is a port channel technology that was only originally developed by Cisco and a switch to switch technology for grouping server fast internet and jump into a one logical channel, so that I think it helps in increasing the bandwidth. So if I have like two, I can use two interface and combine it, like using the maybe TB or two in one TB interface into one. So it's something that maybe having 10 gigabyte, I can have more than 10,000. That's almost like 30 gig that is going through, that is for bandwidth. So it helps in increasing the bandwidth of a connection. So Cisco version of port channel is either what the port aggregation protocol. We all will have a link aggregation protocol. The port aggregation protocol work with Cisco to Cisco, while the link aggregation protocol works with multiple vendors. So I'm going to try to configure some things now. Okay, let's try something. Let's do some configuration. Let me have it TV switch 1, 2, 3. And enable the connection. The connection is this. So it's now from the orange. That means that it's not transitioning. We enable PBGU. Okay, let's switch. Can you see? Now this one is done, it's not changed to green. This one is transitioning from working state to state. Okay. Alright. Okay. Then let's check something. If I'm to check, let's see which one is a root port. Okay, let's start from here. I'm going to show you how and why is a root port. So enable computer. So I can see here this panel tree detail. Root port is 1, cost of root part is 19. So what is our root bridge? Which one is our root bridge? Port part cost is 19. Port priority is 120. Port transfer is this. Port ID. Okay. So spanning tree. Somewhere. Okay. So spanning tree. Because all the switches are in VLAN, that is one VLAN, right? All of them are in VLAN. Enable, that is do show interface with do show IP interface. There's no do because they let me. You can see that I'm only having one VLAN, right? So and when I over my mouse here, I can see that all of them are in VLAN 1111111111. This one is in VLAN 1111111. This one is in VLAN 1. So all the switch are in what? In VLAN 1. So now, showing spanning tree VLAN 1, I can see that my bridge ID priority is 32769. And with this, I can say my cost is 19, port is 1. Root ID is this. Is this my root bridge? No. Cost is 19. Because of what? It is Spartan Summit. Right? Which is 100 megabytes per second. It's 19. So now let me check the other one to look for my root bridge. So now can you see this bridge is the root bridge. So they all did election between each other when they are doing the transition state. We cannot elect this as a root bridge, right? So because this switch is root bridge, priority is 32769. What is the priority is this one? Okay, this is all of them are the same priority. So when all of them are the same priority, they use another thing as what? As for election. In which they use what? Let me check this one. So maybe so spanning tree VLAN 1. So you note that all of them are having the same priority, 32769, right? This one also having the priority of 32769, right? This one also having the priority of 32769. Now, they now use another thing as what? Okay, let me write it. Let's see something. Priority 32769. Priority 32769. Priority 32769. All of them are using priority. Now let's check the MAC address. So let's check their MAC address. So the MAC address of this one is 0007, The MAC address of this is 007 as well. 007, okay, let's check again. PC5B, okay, sorry. Yeah. Okay, now. So, this is the MAC, this is the, can you see, 0007 EC5B 38380. This is the MAC address of the boot file, that is the root boot. So, looking at this, I can see what EC5B, this 38380. Now, looking at this one, I have 008. Now, 007 is less, is less than A. When you are doing your binary 10123456789, there's no 10 master from A, so that means 7 is less than A from A. So let's check this. D, can you see 0 is no less than D? So I can say that what this one is, what is our root boot, because of what, it has a lower MAC address than the two, than this two. So that's why it is what is the bridge ID. Why the cost from here to here is 19. The cost from here to here, because if I have this one to be, I told you that what the root port is always the lowest port, but the least port, the least cost to the root bridge, right? If everything is 19, now if it's passing from here to here, trust me, if it's passing, if you see, you don't have to go from here to here, that's 19 plus 19, that's 38. So 19 is less than 38, so I cannot be going to do through a long distance when you have a shorter distance. So that's why this is what is the root. This one is forwarding, this one is forwarding. You can see for this switch FA02, FA02, they are all what, forward. So now because this one is the root bridge, now this one is the what, root port. This interface here is a root port. Why this one also? This interface is a root port. FA02. So I can see FA01 is a root forward now. Can you see? Because what? It has a lesser part cost. And why this one? It is FA02. Can you see? It's also what? It's also a root port. Forward, root port. I'll put it here. Forward, root port. Root port. Now, why did this one green and this one amber? Why? I can tell you that root spanning tree is operating here. Now what version of spanning tree? Let me check. Okay, I'm going to talk about that one later. Now looking at this one, you can see that this one is green, this one is amber, right? Now what happened here? We all know this one is root port, we all know this one is forwarding, we all know this one is forwarding, we all know this one is root port. No, what is this port? Which state is this port? Which state is this port? Both of them cannot be forwarding. Or designated, no, when one is a root port, the other one is designated port, right? So now which one is, so for me I can see that this one is designated port. Why this one is what? Is the root is the blocking state. So what happened? What happened is about they are going to use two things. Now the first one is about they are going to use the part that is that has the least cost to the root port. Now for me I can see that what I have 19, that is they are both having the same cost to the root port. Okay, you cannot use that one. Now what are you going to use? I'm going to use priority. Okay, you have the same priority. Okay, I have found one. Okay, what's the next thing I'm going to use? Okay, let's use our MAC address. Okay, now let's use our MAC address. So my MAC address is 000A, right? Your MAC address is 00D. So I can see that 000A. Now looking at this, I can see the MAC says starting is 0 0 0 et trois de son vote 0 0 10 10 0 right. Ok, des 0. Now I can see that 0 from the third one to 3, from the third 0 is less than 3, so that's why this one will need the election to have what, to have designated port forward, designated port for FA02. Can you see designated port FA02? Why this one FA01 is now what, is now in a blocking state. So that's how STP is. So that means STP is enabled, because now this one is in blocking state. So if it goes like this, 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 cannot come here again, because this one is blocked. Because if it goes like this, if this one is frozen, this one is regular. If it is simple spanish on top of this one, if it is simple spanish on this one, on this spot, on this suite, trust me, this one is going to be in loop forever and going to work. In fact, the switch is destroyed. So I hope you guys got the concept of spanning tree with this little diagram I made. Now let me now enable port fast. Okay. Now let me see the version of enable panic mode is what, PVST. This one is also what, show one, it's also PVST, show one, it's also PVST. So if I want to change it, I can say okay, key, panic, let me change it. If I want to change it, I can say control T, panic mode, I change it to rapid PVST, rapid PVST. Now I change all show running for resolution. So we can use about it is what rapid PVST. And this one as well. So I'm going to stop here for a moment. So in the next tutorial, I'm going to continue on how to configure port fast and ether channel. Thank you and stay tuned.